Hello, friends. Hello, children. It's pretty weird that we can't go to school, or anywhere else for that matter. So we're going to do a music class this way, see how it goes. So this is for the children of the Montessori Children's House of Lawrence, but also we'd like to invite any friends anywhere to sing along with us and join in. So we will sing some songs and look at some things and talk about stuff. But first, let's do our warm-ups. I usually play the guitar for this, but I like to stand, and because I don't play guitar and stand these days, this is the iPad 1 Real Tambura app. Key of D. We start with ah, a nice open fundamental sound. Ah. Now an O, nice round. Let's go up an octave and back down. Second verse, it's about finding your way in the dark by looking at the stars. It says, tiny traveler in the dark, thank you for your lovely spark. We would not see where to go if you did not twinkle so. Let's try just that one. Tiny traveler. So here we are. We were supposed to have our spring program at the Carnegie Building here in Lawrence, Kansas, in the first week of April. I don't know if that's going to happen, which is disappointing. I know we're all looking forward to it, practicing hard for it, and everybody already had their outfits picked out for it. And this would be the time during class we'd go around the circle. Everyone would tell me what they were wearing. In great detail, for the performance. The important thing is that everyone stay well and that you keep learning, keep singing, keep moving, keep thinking. As you know, a medley is a group of songs put together. And in this case, the songs are All the Birds Have Come Again, I Am a Little Birdie, Sunflower, and Butterfly. And I wish I could show you the movements. Maybe we'll get someone else to do that for us. Ready? Here we go. One, two, ready, go. All the birds have come again with their happy voices. Noisy sparrow, wren so bright, chirp and sing from morn till night, telling us of spring's delight. Everyone rejoices. So we have to be really careful about germs these days, even more careful than before. And a lot of people are wearing these masks. I'll model it for you. There. Not very attractive, but it does the job. So it's hard to know whether those masks are for people who are sick or people who are trying to not be sick. Or everyone. Some people are writing not sick on their masks so others won't be afraid. And some people might want people to think they're sick so they stay away. It's very confusing. Anyway, the surgical masks do a good job. They're not very attractive, not very stylish. How is this? Is this better? Well, if you see someone who looks like this at the store, it might be me. And it's probably just as well that you stay away because I have trouble remembering not to hug my friends when I see them. And you may not want to hug me when I look like this. I don't know. I have a book to share with you today. Actually, I'm not sharing the book, just a couple of riddles out of it. The world's worst riddles. Usually I'm suspicious of things that say they're the worst or the best, but these really are bad. But there's a couple that I actually like and can share with children. What animal can fly higher than a house? all of them, houses can't fly. What did George Washington say to his men just before they got in the boat? Men, get in the boat. All right. Here's one for automobile fans. What do you call a knight with a rotary engine? Don Quixote de la Mazda. Get someone to explain that to you. Some of these jokes are so bad. And it wouldn't be appropriate to share them with you. So learn to read. All right, one more. Why didn't the skeleton cross the road? He didn't have the guts. Not only are the riddles bad, the illustrations. I think almost all of you 3 to 5 year old children could draw a better skeleton than this guy. He didn't have the guts. The joke about the skeleton reminded me of the joke, why did the chicken cross the road? Which reminded me of another joke, why did the chicken cross the Moebius Strip? To get to the same side. That's a physics joke. But that reminded me of a really cool project. I haven't tried it in years. Making a Moebius Strip. So to make a Moebius Strip, get a strip of paper. I've got wax paper. I've been in the kitchen cleaning and cleaning. So I know where this paper was right now. So you take your paper and get tape. Be sure the tape covers the whole paper because you're going to be cutting this in two and you want tape on both sides. So, you know, you'd normally make a loop for a chain. Twist it. Make your loop, but twist it. Tape it down. And now, you might have to get someone to help you with this project. Take it and start it somewhere. You can start it on the part you taped or anywhere else. But you might have to fold it a little bit. Try to get it in the middle. And snip. A place to start your scissors. And let's make 2 Moebius strips, shall we? Cut the whole thing right down the middle. You don't have to be super careful. Keep cutting till you come back around to where you began. Here I am, making the last cut. To get our 2 Moebius strips, and voila, you can't cut a Moebius strip in two. It just makes a bigger Moebius strip. And if we were to cut this one in two, it would just make a bigger Moebius strip, and so on and so on. This is a rare opportunity to be inside my home, which many of you have asked about, and few of you have visited, so I can show you around a bit. This is my little room. I call my studio. Studio. I think that's the same root as the word student and study. And because this is my studio, I cover the walls with whatever I like. The rest of the house, it's a little more grown up. We might see that at some point. And if you sing all these songs, I'm gonna know whether you're singing or not. I'll find the cat and we'll get to meet Koshu Kitty. Meanwhile, let's sing some songs. Monty got me this bookmark of the planets. It's lenticular. Lenticular. You guys know that. That's one of those pictures with two pictures and the light goes back and forth between them and it looks three-dimensional. And the sun is a hot star. 1, 2, 3. The sun is a hot star. Mercury is hot too. Venus is the brightest planet. Earth is home to me and you. Mars is the red one. Jupiter is most wide. Saturn has the shiny rings. Uranus spins on its side. Neptune's very windy. Pluto's very small. We wanted to name the planets and now we name them all. Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, Pluto, and now we name them all. When we do the planet song, the children make an orrery. An orrery is a model of the solar system. And they set it up as a choreographed dance movement. 1, 2, 3. The sun is a hot star. Mercury is hot too. Venus is the brightest planet. Earth is home to me and you. Mars is the red one. Jupiter is most wide. Saturn has the shiny rings. Uranus spins on its side. Neptune's very windy. Pluto's very small. We wanted to name the planets and now we name them all. Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, Pluto, and now we name them all.
Marvelous musical geniuses! Marvelous musical geniuses!